Hello students, welcome to the 24th class on current affairs. And in today's class we'll be dealing with a very important topic, that is the recent amendments that have been introduced to the Prevention of Corruption Act 1988. Now this act has undergone a change, and there are five big changes that the government has brought in this act. Now primarily at the face, the changes have been brought in to fight corruption, to bring in transparency, and to increase the level of accountability. Now, a very important change that has been introduced in the law is about the bribery law. Bribery law. Now, what it means? Now, when it comes to corruption, corruption is actually a two-way process. Now, what it means? It means someone will be instigating the public authority to perform or to conduct a particular job for the one by taking a bribe. So anyone who is instigating, anyone who is actually motivating the public authority to indulge in corruption, he will also be prosecuted under this law of Prevention of Corruption Act 1988. So this is a new change that has been introduced. It is not only the public authority who is indulging in corruption, but the one who is forcing that public authority to indulge in corruption will also be taken care of by the law. But there is very important condition. If someone has paid bribe and that is a forcible bribe, he has been forced to pay the bribe, in that case he can go to police within 7 days. And if he will go to police within 7 days, in that case he will not be charged under the Prevention of Corruption Act 1988. In case he has not gone to police within these 7 days, in that case he will definitely be charged under Prevention of Corruption Act. So now corruption that was earlier viewed only from one-way perspective, now it will be viewed from a two-way perspective. Now, second important change that has been introduced in this Prevention of Corruption Act is with respect to criminal conduct. Criminal conduct related to corruption. Now, when it comes to criminal conduct of someone indulging in corruption, earlier, Prevention of Corruption Act 1988, it had a wider scope. Anyone who was indulging in repeated cases of corruption, anyone who was forcing the other party to give him concession, anyone who was forcing the other party to favor him or provide him some kind of pecuniary benefit, in that case, if someone was indulging in all these activities were categorized as criminal conduct. Kisi se concession lena, kisi ko force karna ki paise de de, और रिपीटेड करप्शन में इंडल्ज होना, ये सारे एपिसोड्स को डिफाइन किया जाता था अंडर क्रिमिनल कंडक्ट. बट ऑफ लेट क्रिमिनल कंडक्ट ये सारा कुछ खत्म कर दिया गया है. देयर आर ओनली टू प्रोविजंस इन द न्यू लॉ इन द क्रिमिनल कंडक्ट. फर्स्ट इज मिस अप्रोप्रिएशन ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टी दैट वन विल हैव, एंड दिस हैज बीन स्पेशली डिफाइंड विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द बैंकर्स. It means you cannot misappropriate the property that you have. It means the government property. You cannot misuse that property. If you will be misusing that property, in that case, you will be charged under the provisions of Prevention of Corruption Act 1988. Now, this is an important thing. Misappropriation. Second important thing is, if you amass disproportionate assets to the sources of income that you have, it means बहुत बड़ा घर बना लिया है बट आपका पे सिर्फ 30,000 रुपया 40,000 रुपया महीना है, इन दैट केस दैट एक्ट ऑफ योर्स विल बी कैटेगराइज्ड एज क्रिमिनल कंडक्ट अंडर प्रिवेंशन ऑफ करप्शन एक्ट. तो पहला पैसा जो इंस्टिगेट करेगा पब्लिक अथॉरिटी को कि करप्शन में इंडल्ज हो जाए, दैट विल अगेन बी नोन एज ब्राइबरी लॉ, समवन हु इज ट्राइंग टू ब्राइब. सेकेंडली द क्रिमिनल कंडक्ट हैज अंडरगोन अ चेंज. Now, thirdly, very important change that has been introduced is with respect to pre-investigation. Now, prima facie, if someone indulges in corruption, earlier the police used to conduct investigation in that case. But from now onwards, after the enactment of this new amendment in Prevention of Corruption Act 1988, now the police will have to seek permission of the relevant authority before indulging in pre-investigation. Now this is very, very important. Pre-investigation has undergone a change. Now this is our retrograde subject. This is a retrograde step. पीछे क्या step है? Forward step नहीं है. इससे corruption जो लोग कर रहा है, उनके against investigation करना मुश्किल हो जाएगा. Criminal conduct में सिर्फ दो को define किया. पहले तीन चीजें थी, वो कम कर दी है. Bribery law, जो पैसा दे रहा है, उसको भी involve करेंगे law के अंदर. Fourth is, means consent has to be taken of the authority under which one was working, higher authority. कि corruption हुआ है कि नहीं हुआ है. Earlier, consent was required only for the serving officers, but now this consent is also required for the officers who have actually retired. तो दो तरह का consent लेना पड़ेगा. जो word है वो actually है sanction for prosecution. तो प्रोसिक्यूट करने के लिए, केस मेंटेन करने के लिए कि किसी ने करप्शन किया है, तो उसे सीनियर ऑफिसर से इंडल्ज परमिशन लेना पड़ेगा. अभी प्री इन्वेस्टिगेशन का भी परमिशन लेना पड़ेगा हायर अथॉरिटी से. बट अगर कोई रेड हैंडेड करप्शन करता हुआ पकड़ा गया है रंगे हाथों, इन दैट केस इन्वेस्टिगेशन विल बी लॉज्ड अगेंस्ट दैट पर्सन. नाउ द फिफ्थ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग दैट हैज अंडरगॉन इज द चेंज ऑफ द प्रिवेंशन ऑफ करप्शन एक्ट is forfeiture of the property. Now what is forfeituring of the property? It means that the government will take the property, government will seal the property, government will take away the property that will be deemed to have been earned by the public authority by indulging in corruption. So the new changes in the Prevention of Corruption Act 1988, they are nothing but a mixed bag of the positives and the negatives. What are the positives? The positive is forfeiture of property. The positive is involving the people who instigate the public authorities to indulge in crime. But the negatives are reducing corruption conduct's scope, plus seeking permission for pre-investigation and also seeking the sanction for prosecution. So this was all for the class. In case you have any doubt with respect to this very class, that is the 24th class on current affairs, you can contact us at 84594-0000. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice, nice day.